Okay, this video is going to be about solving word problems with multiplication and division. So here's the first problem. This says, Jordan owes 4 times as much on his credit card as Isaac. If Jordan owes $824, how much does Isaac owe? Okay, so we're comparing the amount that Jordan owes with the amount that Isaac owes. So I've got this J for Jordan, and an I for Isaac. And it says that Jordan owes 4 times as much as Isaac. So if we multiply the amount of money that Isaac owes by 4, we should get the amount that Jordan owes. Okay, this looks right. Jordan's amount is 4 times Isaac's amount. Now it also tells me that Jordan owes $824. So here we, instead of the J, we can put in the amount that Jordan owes, the 824, and then just copy the rest of the equation. And now I want to find out how much Isaac owes. So I'll just divide both sides of the equation by 4. So let's see, 824 divided by 4. So 4, actually let's do this like we're going division thing just to remember how they do it. So 4 into 8 goes 2 times. 2 times 4 is 8. Subtract, there's no remainder. Bring down the 2. I can't divide 4 into 2, so I'll put a 0 in. Bring down the 4. 4 into 24 goes 6 times. 4 times 24, 4 times, 6 times 4 is 24. There's no remainder. So 824 divided by 4 would be 206, and 4i divided by 4 would just be I, so the amount that Isaac owes is $206. And we can check that by working backwards. If Jordan owes 4 times as much as Isaac, then what we want to see is 824 the same as 4 times the amount that Isaac owes, which is 206. So multiplying that out, we get 824. So this answer is going to check, and in writing your answer out, you'll write Isaac owes $206. Okay, here's another one. Michelle is 1/3 as old as Brian. If Michelle is 7, how old is Brian? Okay, so I'm comparing Michelle's age and Brian's age. And Michelle is 1/3 as old as Brian. So let's see. That would mean that if we knew 1/3 of Brian's age, that would be the same as Michelle's age. So we should take Brian's age and divide it by 3, and then we would have an equation that balanced. Michelle's age is 1/3 of Brian's age. She's 1/3 as old as Brian. Now, it says that Michelle is 7. So instead of using an M, I can just write a 7. So 7 equals B for Brian over 3. If I want to find out what the B equals, I'll multiply both sides by 3. On the left side, I'm going to get 21. On the right side, the 3s will cancel, and I'll just have B. So Brian's age is 21. And again, you can make sure that checks. Michelle is 1/3 as old as Brian. Well, if Brian is 21, 1/3 of Brian's age, 1/3 of 21 is 7, and that's how old Michelle is. Okay? So this answer is okay also. Here's the last one. A roommate agrees to pay 1/4 of the total monthly rent for an apartment. Okay, so we have the roommate share and the total amount. So let's use R for the amount the roommate is going to pay. And let's use a T for the total amount. but she's not going to pay the total amount. She's only going to pay 1/4 of the total. So she's paying the total divided by 4. Okay? Now it also tells me that she pays $415. So the roommate's rent, roommate's share of the rent, is $415. And that's going to equal T over 4, the total amount divided by 4. To solve this for T, I'll just multiply both sides by 4. Multiplying 4 times 415. Let's do this over here. 4 times 415. So 4 times 5 is 20. I've got to carry a 2. 4 times 1 is 4. Plus 2 is 6. 4 times 4 is 16. So the total rent over here is 1,660. These 4s cancel. So this amount should be the total rent. And again, we could check that. We could divide this by 4, and that should get us back to the 415, the amount that she pays. And then we would know for sure that it checks. Okay, so be careful when you set these up. Think things through before you jump into it, and you should be fine. Take care. See you next time.